Alright, Dan here with a quick video. This is just going to be a quick unboxing video. I recently discovered a surplus website called Army Surplus Warehouse, and they had some cool vintage stuff. And I had found out about that through a Facebook page I'm on called U.S. Field Gear Junkies, and someone was asking about M1 helmets they had listed. They were listed rear seams, for which you know, who those don't know, rear seams are post World War II, for like $15 to $20, and they had front seams listed for under $100, just shells, you know, no straps or anything. But they just had a generic photo, and the person was asking if anybody had ordered from them, and you know what condition the helmet might be, whatever. But when I saw an M1 helmet shell for $15, I thought that's one hell of a deal. I'll take a chance and see what I get. So I don't really know what I'm going to get when I open this up. It's going to be a dinged up, rusted up helmet. If it is, I'll restore it. If it's pretty nice, well, I'll make it a complete helmet. So let's see what we find out. See if I did well for $15 plus shipping. I said, I don't know. They just had a generic photo of an M1 helmet, so don't know what condition it'll be in. And there it is, and well, wow. Okay, let's put that box aside. That's actually a really pretty nice M1 helmet shell. It's got the late paint on it. It's got the sand texture, the lighter green paint. It is a rear seam. So this would be a Vietnam era production. Could have been used all the way through the 80s. Little scuffs. A little ding there. But overall, that is a really nice M1 helmet shell. So, it looks like we got a... it's going to be hard to see. But there's a there's your lot code right there. And what does it say? It says 507. So I'll have to do a little research on that and see where this particular M1 helmet was made and when it was made. I know some of these were made, Canada did a run of M1s in the 70s that apparently weren't very good, but I'm guessing this is in fact a U.S. Helmet, so we'll do a little research. But that's just a quick unboxing, and for $15, I think I did pretty well. So, like I said, check out that website, Army Surplus Warehouse, if you're looking for an M1. And I'll be back with some more videos.